Hey, Jim, the program's about to begin. And the one, and the two, and the you know what to do.
Thanks, Arvid. I'll take it from here.
Oh, we're back in the saddle again. So welcome to the roundup, my friends. We've got some catching up to do and news we want to share with you, 'cause we're back in the saddle again. Our doors are wide open once more, and we've got riders and volunteers galore. Programs and lessons, yes siree, including hippotherapy. We're River Valley riding, that's for sure. Whoop-dee-tie-i-o, watch the carriage drivers go, back in the saddle again. Whoop-dee-tie-i-a, time to get things underway, 'cause we're back in the saddle again.
Good evening, and welcome to the 2021 River Valley Riders Roundup. I'm Jim Detmar, and I am honored to serve as your MC for the evening. We got a lot to get to, so right now, please welcome from all the way across the North 40, River Valley Riders co-founder and executive director, Cheryl Holt. Cheryl, good evening.
Hello.
Good to see you. Look, I'd like to stick around, but I got to run. I'll be back. Arvid, grab my coat.
All right. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to River Valley Riders' second virtual Roundup Gala. This year, we were able to bring some of you together for our first watch party. Hello to all of you watching from Jimmy's Event Center. I know you're having a blast. And hello to all of you watching from the comfort of your homes. And we appreciate your commitment to River Valley Riders. Our mission remains strong, to enrich the lives of children and adults with special needs by providing equine-assisted services. And we do this by providing programming involving wonderful horses, both for riding and carriage driving. So let's first talk about RVR's history. Our first 20 years has shown much growth. We saw there was a great need for these types of services, so we established River Valley Riders in the fall of 1999, opening for our first lessons the spring of 2000 at the Washington County Fairgrounds. The demand for these services continued to grow and fostered our dream of owning our own land and facility. We purchased 38 acres in Afton in 2009 and had our first lessons on site the fall of 2011. We continue to improve the property, and our greatest improvement so far was our fully insulated indoor arena, which helps us avoid weather cancellations and be more comfortable in the heat and cold. This indoor arena has allowed us to expand programming. Secondly, let's talk about 2021. This year was definitely closer to normal. Programming started in April of 2021, and it was so wonderful to see everyone again. However, we did have to start out slowly, but we were in full programming by the end of July, and no major hiccups. Here are a few comments directly from our participants' families. Improved my daughter's confidence. She cannot imagine her life without RVR. And RVR has been a huge blessing in my daughter's life. Since my son started riding with RVR, he is more motivated and has progressed emotionally and physically, brings joy to the family. We are definitely grateful for all the love, energy, and dedication of everyone associated with River Valley Riders. Our son loves his time doing these activities. The people make it happen, and the horses too. We also established a new RVR North Metro site in May Township at the home of Gary and Gail Olson. A special thank you to Gail and Gary. This program started up in June with full programming by the end of July. RVR also established a partnership with Unbridled Abilities to offer hippotherapy for the first time. Thank you to Madeline Bow, owner of Unbridled Abilities. She is a speech language pathologist and PATH certified instructor. Madeline's program is focused on speech with the aid of the horse. The term hippotherapy refers to the use of the movement of the horse as a treatment strategy by physical therapists, occupational therapists, and speech-language pathologists to address impairments, functional limitations, and disabilities in patients with neuromotor and sensory dysfunction. This is a one-on-one program with rider and therapist. Have you ever had a dream so big, so daunting, so risky that it is absolutely terrifies you? But you pursue it anyway? That is RVR. Dreams are supposed to be big, open, expansive ideas that you chip away at day by day, step after step. That is what we've been doing over these past years with all your help. We are staying the course and moving forward to our dream to its full realization. To continue the growth that enables RVR to realize our dream, providing more services to more riders, we will do this by building an entire facility, fully staffed, and have our own horses on site. However, we always remember that what happens in the buildings is far more important than the buildings themselves. There is no greater disability in society than the inability to see a person as more. Many of our participants do not come to RVR to learn to ride a horse, but to grab the reins on their life and show it who's boss. Here are more comments directly from our participants' families. Built up my daughter's self-esteem, pride, confidence, and improved her communication. She feels calm and joy on riding days. My child has gained confidence and improved social skills at RVR, which help at school and other activities. We cannot express enough just how much RVR means to us. The confidence built at RVR has fully spilled over into school, improving his reading and math skills, improved communication skills as he can talk about his activity of horseback riding. So our dream is now in phase two, and we made some progress on this in this phase in 2020. The driveway and parking lot are paved, and we brought in natural gas for the heat. But we still need your help to complete this phase, which includes office building shell with finished viewing room and indoor bathrooms, heated office space, and a mounting annex. Please keep in mind that this is a multi-year fundraising effort, and tonight's Fund the Vision goal is $70,000. That $70,000 will complete our multi-year $300,000 matching grant from the FS Foundation and will bring us much closer to realizing our dream. Our participants' smiles and successes fuel our passion. Success is not always the outcome, but more so who you become. We are working to create more smiles. And more smiles and more riders and drivers is RVR's ultimate goal. We want to expand our programming and offer year-round lessons. Have a complete facility with horses on site is the formula to complete our vision, our dream. Help us with our next step. Thank you. Now, I would like to invite you to watch this video, which will be introduced by our CFO, Development Director, and Carriage Driving Instructor, Kathy Johansson.
Hello from Afton. Many of our participants, families, and volunteers tell me this is their favorite place to be. I agree. This is home base for our riders and drivers' achievements, increased confidence, and smiles of joy. We hope you are inspired hearing directly from our participants, Rosalind, Madeline and her mom, and longtime volunteer, Peggy.
I originally contacted RVR because I was interested in riding because I needed to improve my core strength. My horse's name is Tanner, and Tanner is wonderful to work with. Not knowing what I was doing in the very beginning, he put up with everything that I was doing and kept right on going, and it didn't seem to faze him that much. Each week when I come to drive, Peggy and Linda are just wonderful and have been great to work with. Everybody that is here has been so supportive and so helpful and so patient.
Volunteering with Roz has been just a joy. I would say that My favorite thing about Roz is she inspires me. She's just an awesome lady. Life threw her a curveball, and instead of retracting, she just goes right ahead with life, and whatever she wants to do, she finds a way to do it. And I'm inspired by her. And I feel really special to be able to spend time with her. And I love it. Each and every week, I look forward to seeing her.
Carriage driving at RVR has just been a freeing experience that makes me feel like I'm not handicapped at the moment. Being in the cart and driving, it has given me a freedom that I won't get any other way. I'm not different from anyone else that would be in the cart and driving. And it's a wonderful feeling to be able to feel that way.
My story about RVR is that my mom signed me up so I could do horseback riding and get my legs and back stronger.
We were at the fair, either the county fair or the state fair, and I saw some flyers about RVR. And I was interested because I thought Madeline would really like it because she likes animals and it would be a safe way for her to ride. So I went home and went online and looked them up and then saw that they have two locations and one of them is 10 to 12 minutes from our house. So we decided to give it a shot.
The reason why I came to RVR is because I could ride horses, and that is my favorite thing. I'm pretty excited to see Pickles every Wednesday. Miss Pickles is always kind and sweet and always hardworking. My favorite place to ride is outside in the riding ring when it's nice and warm and cool.
Madeline has experienced many benefits from River Valley riding. She's more social. She gets to do something that is outside of the norm, especially for kids like her that have some challenges or extra needs. And her core has gotten stronger, and she's improved her balance overall, not just on the horse, but also in walking and riding a bike and doing other things. Watching Madeline ride is like opening up presents on Christmas Day because she's so excited to do it, especially if she gets to trot, because trotting is very bumpy and she just giggles the whole time. But it's empowering to see her do something that she loves when many people would think she walks with forearm crutches or she uses a wheelchair and she could never get on a horse. So it's really fun to see her do something that a lot of people think she couldn't be able to do. I would absolutely recommend RVR to other families that have children with special needs. RVR is unique and it's fun, but it's also easy to get to. The parking lot here is all paved, so if you have a kiddo in a wheelchair or needs to walk with assistance, it's really easy to get in and out of your vehicle. And I've seen lots of benefits to Madeline and the rest of our family because she gets to have this unique and therapeutic experience.
Wow, what a great testament, not only to the services River Valley Riders provides, but also to the determination, enthusiasm, and relentless optimism of our riders. And you know, before we go any further, Madeline, I know you're watching, and we have a special message for you from an old friend.
Madeline, my favorite days are being outside, trotting around with you on my back, hearing you giggle. Thanks for being my friend.
She's gonna love that. Well done.
Friends, indeed. You know, volunteers, regardless of where they offer their time and their service, will be the first to tell you, I get as much back out of volunteering as I give, perhaps even more. And the volunteers at River Valley Riders are no different. Yet the selfless nature they exhibit and their dedication to making a difference in the lives of the riders and their families is undeniable and is on display every day in every way.
River Valley Riders is a volunteer-intense organization. We use about 200 volunteers a year. Sometimes our riders or drivers need 3 volunteers each, depending upon their ability. We have a large all-day training in the spring of the year, And then we have monthly trainings throughout the year. So even if an individual cannot join us right away in the beginning of the season, they're able to come together with us during the season. It's so fun to watch our volunteers grow in their experience with River Valley Riders. It is a rewarding experience. Many times I've heard volunteers tell me that they have come to RVR thinking they are going to give, and then they tell me they seem to receive more than they give. They build a strong relationship with the riders and with their fellow volunteers.
My name is Angela. And I learned about River Valley Riders through a friend that used to be a volunteer here. I volunteer here because I really like to help people. I'm a nurse, and it's just natural for me to wanna do something different and help people to achieve their goals. The relationships here at River Valley Riders have been spectacular, not just with the volunteers, but with the riders. Oftentimes, you're getting the same rider week after week, so you really get to know them, you get to know their goals, and you're better able to help them reach their goals. They look forward to seeing you, you look forward to seeing them, lots of high fives and everything are going on. And in addition to that, you get to know the other volunteers as well, so that's been pretty cool too. I definitely would recommend being a volunteer at River Valley Riders.
If you'd like to become a volunteer with River Valley Riders, please visit our website at rivervalleyriders.org.
And here to talk about all things financial, Treasurer Tom Cowboy!
Arvid, it's Conboy, not Cowboy. Conboy.
Oh, please welcome Tom Conboy. That'll make the blooper reel.
Yes, it will.
Thank you, Arvid. And Arvid, I haven't forgot that bite you've given me this year either. Still healing up. RVR got through the pandemic of 2020 standing strong with the help of all our donors. Thank you very much. This allowed us to start limited programming in April and then expand to full programming in July. And right now we're on the path to start up full programming in April of next year. This Roundup Gala is our biggest fundraiser, supporting both operations and fund the vision for the future. Operations supports the programming, the horses, the facility maintenance, and Fund the Vision supports expanding the programming, serving more people by improving the facilities. We depend on the continued support of all of you to keep us growing so we can provide more services to more families. Again, thank you for your support and confidence as we continue to provide this valuable service to our community. You know, the relationship between a participant and their volunteer is very special and unique. One we see day in and day out at RVR.
What brought us to River Valley Riders was after Grant was diagnosed at age 3 with Coulin-DeVries syndrome, we started looking for activities for him to do. And I found River Valley Riders in an article about them and wanted to get Grant involved. He immediately fell in love with the activity.
It's all he talks about when he's getting ready. When it's the day of, he knows it's horses day.
Yep, it's his favorite day of the week.
It's the time he wakes up.
He started when he was 4, and before that, he was a little less verbal. And so he would just get all excited and start shaking his arms and legs as soon as we turned into the driveway. And he knew that it was riding night.
He was comfortable with the horses right away.
Yep.
It was just kind of his thing.
Yep. His sidewalker's name is Grant, and our Grant calls him Big Grant, and he runs right up to him when he gets out of the car and gives him a hug, and they just have this cute bond. They tell jokes and tell each other about their day, and they can't wait to see each other the following week.
Yeah, as soon as he'll run up to him, it'll be, hey, Big Grant, you know, how was your day?
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Yeah.
I met Grant probably about 6-7 years ago. He started coming to RVR, and of course he has the same name as me, so we kind of connected and we just seemed to bond. My favorite story with Grant was probably during a Halloween party here. He dressed up as Scooby-Doo and I dressed up as Shaggy, and we had a great time together.
He ho, he ho, co.
He mowed, and then back up.
I would say the improvements we've seen is he is very confident when he's on the horse and even off the horse. Posture is really great. Mm-hmm. He's listening to the lesson and to the activities that they're going to be doing for the night and the announcements. So
whenever they ask for a volunteer who wants to go next, he's always, I'll go.
Yep.
You know, right away is the first one to answer.
The addition of the indoor arena was a huge blessing.
It used to be we'd wake up in the morning and it was, you know, my riding day. And then it would rain later, and then we wouldn't be able to come, and yep. He'd be so sad because that was his day. And
or it was too hot.
Or it was too hot, or, you know, whatever it was. So it's so nice to have the indoor arena.
When we're watching Grant ride, we're so happy and proud of him that he's found something that he really enjoys. And it just fills us with joy to see him having fun and connecting with all the volunteers. I would recommend River Valley Riders to other special needs children and families 100%.
It's a wonderful organization.
Been wonderful. Yep.
And that's it. Boom.
Awesome. Remember, as Cheryl said earlier, our goal is $70,000, which will compete the FS Foundation matching grant of $300,000. Just to clarify, though, what everybody knows that that means, that we've already raised in our group $230,000. The $70,000 will be $300,000, and then we'll get a matching grant of $300,000, which is $600,000 total for us. Tonight is a big deal, and it brings us closer to realizing the Phase 2 build, which will increase participation by 15%. The stage of the build includes an office building and a heated observation room, indoor bathrooms, an office, and a small classroom. Plus, the mounting annex will be increased in size and usable space. Right now, that space has a ramp and viewing areas. It's about 30 feet total area. We have a good start to our goal of 70,000. Right now, we're up over 52,000.
That's amazing.
Awesome. And I would like to thank the following people that have already generously donated to River Valley Riders. Over 13,000 from Dick Brennan. Thank you, Dick.
Awesome. 13,000.
Thank you to Nancy and Mark Mammel for $5,900. $5,000 from Cheryl and Todd Holt. Thanks, guys.
Well done.
$2,500 from Kathleen Miner, a board officer. Thank you, Kathleen. And $1,500 from Carol and Robert Pribno. Thank you guys very much.
And the giving just keeps coming, Tom. Awesome. We've got $1,000 donations from the following people: Carrie and Dan Rominski, Jerry and Cher Raftery, Liz Niehaus, Cheryl and Chuck Whitmore. It's amazing.
Awesome. And you know, Jim, Cheryl shares her horse with RVR too.
Go figure. Awesome. Of course, they keep giving, don't they?
Awesome.
Also, we got $500 from Jonathan and Tesha Distant, Scott and Becky Rube, Janice Hogan Schildgen, and Maureen Cosgrove. $500 from each of those folks, too. Amazing. Now, if you haven't got a chance to give yet, you can do it now. We invite you to be a part of the success story. So to make a donation, please text RVR to 56651, or you can make a donation on ClickBid by clicking the donate button at the top of the page. And I know that we've had some come in just in the short time we've been talking now. Who else is on tap here?
We have. So for Fund the Vision, we have Jill Steves for $1,500.
Well done, Jill.
Marilis Berry for $1,000.
Nice.
Neil and Peggy Spofford for $1,000.
Thanks, Neil and Peggy.
And Neil, great volunteering with Neil through these last couple years, too. Tim and Sandy Ward, $1,000.
Well played.
Tim, a board member, and Sandy does a lot of photography, which some of what you've seen tonight. And Kath Muckla, $500. Beverly Girth, $500. And Teresa and Kelly Daly, $500. Oh, and we're adding more.
They're just typing right now. It's pins and needles to find out. We know who it is.
We're getting there. More money coming in, they're going to tell you. Oh, okay. Yvonne and Kent Eklund, all the way from Florida.
Florida.
For $500.
All right. Well awesome. Done.
Thanks, Yvonne.
The Sunshine State, brought a little sun here.
That's
now,
right.
Now, I know that you've also got some things that you want to check out
Thank
there
you.
As those names come in, so gather those things. We'll have it back out in just a minute.
Sounds good.
All right. Thanks, Tom. In sports terminology, a triple threat is a person who is proficient in three important skills within their particular field. So joining us now to share her triple threat perspective of River Valley Riders, please welcome board member, participant, and volunteer, Sue Klein. Sue, welcome.
Hello, Jim.
It's Thank been a
you.
Year since we saw
been.
You last. Welcome. So glad you're here.
Thank you.
You bet.
If there's one thing that people who know me say about me, it's that I am a true animal lover. The animals that have been in my life have given me so much love and friendship, which has helped me to cope with pain and depression that have come with my disability. After losing my soul dog in 2010, I knew I needed to find something to get me out of my funk and to help build up my mind, body, and spirit. That's when I learned about River Valley Riders, which has helped me check all those boxes. It was one of the only places that I found that accepted adults into its programs. River Valley Riders has strengthened my mind. Through riding, I've discovered I can transcend the limits of my body. It may take three people to get me on the horse, but once I'm on, it's just me and my horse communicating and bonding. I'm doing something that many able-bodied people have never even tried. I'm not only a rider at RVR, but I'm also become a volunteer and a member of the board. It feels good to give back to an organization that has helped me so much. River Valley Riders has strengthened my body. Imagine how uncomfortable you would feel after sitting for a couple hours. Think of the number of times since you've been sitting here that you've crossed and uncrossed your legs and shifted your weight. Now imagine if you have to sit in that one chair all day, every day, for years. Through riding, I get to feel the freedom of leaving my chair behind. In doing so, I gain core strength, better balance, and through the movement of my horse's gait, my tight hip and back muscles loosen. River Valley Riders has strengthened my spirit. When I'm out in public, it seems sometimes people only see my chair and the limitations they assume I have. That is until I start talking to them about my life and the things that I do, including riding. They go away saying things like, "You're such a strong woman, and I'm inspired by you." And I feel proud of myself for my accomplishments and for continuing to fight to improve my life. I'm so grateful to have found RVR for all these reasons and also for the many great friendships I have formed in the process. I cannot imagine my life without River Valley Riders. Thank you so much for supporting us.
Thank you so much,
Sue. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you not only for sharing your story, but for everything that you do to contribute to RVR.
It's an honor.
Incredible. Well, thank you for being
thank
here.
Thank you.
It's an honor to see you. All right. We're going to move on to the premier auction items, but you know, you've got a Cheshire grin on your face. What's going on that I don't know?
Well, I thought that 52,000 was higher than originally thought we were at that point. And it turns out that, you know, somebody from an anonymous donation donated $10,000.
Oh my goodness.
Just before we were talking today.
$1,000?
$10,000 anonymous bonus. So whoever the anonymous donor, thank you very much. Really appreciate it.
Wow, that is exciting. You know, and we're also excited right now to talk to you about the premier auction items that are up for bid this evening. Now, if you haven't had a chance to start bidding yet, the information is on your screen. And remember, the auction closes at 9 o'clock sharp. So, Tom, take it away. Let's get rolling.
All right. So we're going to talk about the premier auctions. And this is not these are not deals, right? We're giving you good premier auction items to raise some money. So feel free to bid high and bid often.
Yes.
Okay. So we'll start the premier auction with the Cragen's five-star package, which includes a two-night stay in a hotel, unlimited golf, daily breakfast, nightly dinners, and a Gull Lake cruise $70 gift certificate. Cragen's is near Brainerd in Gull Lake, an easy 2 to 3 hour drive from the Twin Cities. Easy.
Yep.
There are many other activities in the area, too. This vacation package was donated by our board chair, Kathy Doucette. Thank you, Kathy.
That's great. And I got to tell you, right now, I'm looking over at the That bid is currently at $544, which is just an odd bid to begin with, but it's got to be higher, folks. We can do better than $544 for a trip up to Cragen's. So get your bidding hands ready and go after it. Item number two, you're going to have to get some skin in the game if you want to take home this next item. But fortunately for you, Artistry Aesthetics' palette of advanced skincare treatments enhance your beauty with state-of-the-art services to help you age with grace. Too late for me, but there's still a shot for you, Tom. Trust me. You will be uniquely assessed and given a treatment plan tailored to your individual needs. Satisfaction and safety are number one. Karina Duran and her team believe in going above and beyond to assure you the safest and most comfortable experience possible. And this $1,000 gift card was generously donated by Artistry Aesthetics in Forest Lake. And right now, the bid is at $1,000. That's just even. We can do better than even. Let's bump that up if we can. Tom, back to you.
That's an awesome bid for that. I'll tell you what, though. You know, I do have a face for radio, and I should have used some of that before I got on here today, for sure. So let me tell you about the Duluth Beach House. Enjoy Duluth, a 2 to 3 day stay at Duluth Beach House. You can browse through the canal shops and restaurants. You can visit the aquarium, and then there's a train museum there too. You can take a walk or simply stroll the beach to the aerial lift bridge to watch the ship traffic. And being an ex-Navy guy, I definitely like watching those big ships and big merchants come in every day. It's quite the scene. All within walking distance of this 3-bedroom lakeside home. If you want to visit Bentleyville for the Christmas holidays, the home will be available December 10th through 13th. Otherwise, your stay in 2022, and thank you to Jan and Bonnie Ryers who have donated this enjoyable getaway.
Yeah, and where are we at, Tom, right now? I think we are at $640 is the current bid. Again, we can do better. All right, our next item is a 4-course Mediterranean dinner for six, prepared by Nancy Allen, and will be hosted near Badamakaska in Minneapolis at a date agreeable to all. Now, when we say Mediterranean, it's not only a place, but a state of mind. The food is simple, unpretentious, and satisfying to eat because of its freshness. The 4-course meal will include appetizers, wine, and appropriate drinks to match each course. Now, Tom, lamb is one of the main ingredients. Also, couscous, yogurts, figs, dates, and prunes. Just great stuff. And this unique experience was donated by Nancy Allen and Jill Steves. And I think right now we are at $600 for the 4-course dinner. I think it should be $8,000 to $1,000, if not more. That's just me. It's worth it.
It definitely should be and could be. And hey, you know what? Kathy Jo will make the baklava for dessert. So she's really good at that. So
wow.
It's worth $900 right there.
At least.
All right. So the next item for a premier auction is Ruby's Grand Adventure for Two. Mm. And it features horseback riding through some of the most beautiful scenic areas around Bryce Canyon National Park. And if you know me, you know I love national parks and I love being out in the wild and the wilderness. So this is one feeds right to me for sure. So you might have to steal it from me if you don't bid higher than where we're at. And we'll get to that in a minute. This includes 5 nights lodging at the Best Western Bryce Canyon Grand Hotel, 4 days of horseback riding, 5 nights of dinner and entertainment, and RVR instructor Linda Kutznan and longtime volunteer Ann Delmont just returned from this trip and have shared their beautiful photos that you're seeing right now.
And they are lovely.
Awesome.
Just absolutely.
This opportunity is so special that reservations are now booking into the 2023 season. So Ruby's Inn Inc. donated this amazing horseback adventure.
And right now, it stands at, tell us, Tom, what do we got?
We are at $2,880.
Not bad. Again, I just think we can do better. Now, everyone, please be sure to check out all the details, all the items, and all the restrictions when you bid on any of our items in the ClickBid auction. You know, Tom, it's gone by quick, but it is about time for us to wrap up our 2021 River Valley Roundup so us early risers can hit the hay, you know?
That's right, Jim. But before we sign off, Cheryl has a few final thoughts for us, and then Arvid and Miss Pickles will serenade us on our journey home. Cheryl?
Thank you. Thanks, Tom, and thank you, Jim, for hosting our program tonight. And thank all of you for being with us. I hope our program gave you a good understanding of River Valley Riders, our participants, our volunteers, our accomplishments, and our dream for the future. And because of your generous support, River Valley Riders will continue to grow and provide more opportunities for people with special needs and help us to achieve our phase two build even sooner. Our focus is what happens in the buildings. Because our riders are more than their diagnosis, and RVR is more than a pony ride. We are a bridge from a life in a box to a life without boundaries, now and into the future. Good night, and thanks for joining us.
Ladies and gentlemen, the incredible Miss Pickles, a 5, 6, 7.
Happy trails to you. We've rounded up once more. Happy trails to you. Time to be heading for the door.
Yee-haw.
So glad we had this precious time together. And tomorrow wear a saddle made of leather. Happy trails to you. Till we meet again. Bye-bye.